While addressing the New Year press conference at Parliament, members of the Buganda Parliamentary Caucus tasked government to account for the 9,000 square miles of public land, which is in custody of government, before fronting changes in the Milo land reforms.
Last 38 years or so, under the stewardship of President Yoweri Museveni, a new concept came in immediately when we went in for the 1995 constitution. Those who had, were they leases, okay, all vibanja on public land for 10 years on the day of promulgation of that constitution consequently became free holders of that land. That means they became true owners of that land in perpetuity.
Legislators highlighted that public land has been parcelled out to foreigners and other rich people in total disregard of the process. They want government to carry out an audit on the people who are allocated public land to ascertain whether they are using the land as they requested.
Having toured some parts of Uganda, we are continuing even in the coming month with our tours, is that a lot of land eviction and land grabbing actually is happening on the so-called 9,000 square miles, Kenda, under the free ownership. And the people who are evicting can also be traced.
Let us get the list. Let us also get the process through which they went in order to acquire the public land.
The caucus chairperson, Muhammad Muwanga Chivumbi, has challenged the government to make use of the land fund to compensate all Milo land owners in Buganda. MPs wonder why the government is using the land fund to buy land for people in other regions of the country and not in Buganda region where the dual land tenure system reigns.
Dual ownership, which President Museveni is trying to settle elsewhere but not in Buganda. He's trying to settle it outside Buganda by using public funds in the land fund, creating titles and giving them out outside Buganda. We have seen it in Bunyoro.
The Buganda caucus members decried rampant land grabbing and evictions that have dominated the central region. According to the annual police crime report of 2021, land-related crimes increased by 4%, with 332 very serious land-related cases reported to CID headquarters alone.
New land acquisition is descending on forested land, rainforests. Here, they are no longer going to the vibanjas. No. You'll cry plasma. You'll scare them because it is a source of livelihood. But a source of livelihood which is not direct are the forest lands. These ones have been destroyed all over. And they simply pay 320,000 to acquire miles of forested land. They harvest the forest, they sell the firewood and the timber, and then they plant pine. They own that land for 99 years. None of us will be here. So they will establish a new race of people where we belonged. And this is something that we cannot take while sitting.
Buganda region is also concerned with the recent creation of constituencies and other administrative units, which according to MPs is not equitable. They believe the region has not fairly benefited from wealth creation programs where resources are shared on the basis of constituencies and parishes.
Quite a fair formula. Let's apply it across the board. The board. Our view is that you need a leaner, smaller, efficient government. We strongly believe in it, and you know we advocate for it.
But we shall also give you numbers relating to how government has been spending per region for the last 5 years, and you see the inequity. So when we sit here as Buganda caucus, we mean business.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.